inverse normal distribution. So what is inverse normal distribution? Let's review the normal distribution. So the variable x follows normal distribution, the mean, mu, and the variance. And the probability that x is smaller than x equals p. P is the probability of x is smaller than the small x. Now we also know Z score. This is Z equals x minus mu over the standard deviation. And we also know the probability that x is smaller than small x equals the probability that z is smaller than small x minus mean over the standard deviation. Here, the z follows the standard normal distribution. The mean is 0 and the variance is 1. We know all of this. And we already know, when we know the mean and the variance and the value of small x, we can find the probability p with calculator. And the inverse normal distribution tells us when the mean, the variance, and the probability is known, how to get the value of small x. Or when the probability and the value of x are known, how to get the mean and the variance. Next, let's see an example. Let's see this example. X follow normal distribution, the mean mu, and the variance here. It asks us to find mu and the standard deviation if. So there are two questions here. The first question is, if the probability that X is bigger than 7 equals 0.8, and the probability that X is smaller than 6 equals 0.1. So if we know this, if we know these probabilities and the value of small x related to the probabilities, if we know this, how to find the mu and the standard deviation? So we solve the question. So first, the question one. So we know the probability that x is smaller than 7 equals 1 minus the probability that x is bigger than 7. So this equals 1 minus 0.8. And this equals 0.2. And we know the probability that z is smaller than 7 minus mu over standard deviation equals the probability that x is smaller than 7. So this equals 0.2. After knowing this equals 0.2, we use calculator. We can find that 7 minus mu over the standard deviation equals negative 0.842. And then we know that the probability that x is smaller than 6 equals 0.1. And then we know that the probability that z is smaller than 6 minus mu over standard deviation equals the probability that x is smaller than 6. So this equals 0.1. So we know this one equals 0.1. And use calculator, we can find that 6 minus mu over standard deviation equals negative 1.482. And this is equation 1. This is equation 2. So from equation 1, get 7 minus mu equals negative 0.842 multiply standard deviation. So this is equation 3. And from 2, get 6 minus mu equals negative 1.482 multiply the standard deviation. This is equation 4. Use 3 to minus 4. We get 1 equals 0.44 multiply standard deviation. Then the standard deviation equals 2.27. After knowing the standard deviation, we can get the mean equals 8.91. Now let's do question 2. So the probability that x is smaller than 150 equals 1 minus the probability that x is bigger than 150. And this equals 1 minus 0.3 equals 0.7. So the probability that z smaller than 150 minus mu over standard deviation equals the probability that x is smaller than 150. This equals 0.7. So we know this probability equals 0.7. Use calculator, we can get that 150 minus mu over standard deviation equals 0.524. So this is equation 1. And the probability that that is smaller than 120 minus mu over standard deviation equals the probability that x is smaller than 120. So this equals 0.4. Use calculator, we can get that 120 minus mu over the standard deviation equals negative 0.253. This is equation 2. So from 1, get 150 minus mu equals 0.524 multiply standard deviation. This is equation 3. And from 2, get 120 minus mu equals negative 0.253 multiply standard deviation. This is equation 4. Use 3 to minus 4. We get 30 equals 0.777 multiply standard deviation. So we can get the standard deviation equals 38.61. After knowing the standard deviation, we can get the mean mu equals 129.768.